you make a video about how to download and install FreeCAD?
Raymond Bram, I got you covered.
If you're new to making or an element of it, getting open source software or free software is a great place to start. Especially if you're learning something new that you're not necessarily sure you're going to continue with. Professional software can be expensive and it might be something you want to work up to. Given that the internet can be a bit of a shady place, you probably need to be careful around where you get your open source software from. So in this video, I'm going to show you how I downloaded and installed FreeCAD.
To find the FreeCAD installer, I start with an internet search, making sure that I've spelt it correctly, as often misspellings will return results that are not related at best to fake software at worst. In this search, the first result is an advert from Google, which may or not be related to what you're looking for. Looking at the second result, it appears to be what we're looking for. The domain name looks legitimate, and the data that Google has found out about the site shows there are more in-depth areas. Now that I'm happy with the link from the search results, I give the website the once-over before I download any software. This site looks clean and professional, has good community links. Someone's taken a bit of time to make this site look good. Spelling, formatting, look and feel are all important for detecting a fake site. Once again, now that I'm happy I'm in the right place to get the right software, it's time to download it. Clicking the Download Now button takes me to the download area where I need to select the platform and operating system that I'm using. Here, I have some choices between Windows, Mac, or Linux. As I'm using Windows, this is the option I'll be using. Now it's downloaded, it's time to install. I click the download located at the bottom of the browser to start the process. At this point, Windows asks me if I'm sure if I want to install. Once accepted, the wizard comes up. To start the installation process, click Next. I'm then presented with the license agreement. When I'm ready to proceed, I click Next. The wizard then asks me if I want to install software for all users on the computer or just me. You'll need to choose what's right for you, but I chose all users. Next, you need to specify where to install the software. I just chose the default location, which is probably program files. The wizard then asks if you want to associate certain file types to FreeCAD and if I want a desktop icon. I try to keep a clean desktop, so I unselect this option and click Next. Next up, I'm prompted for the name of the start menu folder. For simplicity, I select the default folder name. Once I click Next, the wizard goes ahead and installs the software based on the information I've entered. Finally, the wizard completes the installation and gives me the option to launch FreeCAD. Clicking the Finish button completes the installation. And that's it! FreeCAD is now installed and ready to be used to design your next amazing project. So why not let me know what projects you're going to use FreeCAD for down in the comments? Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next video.